Hey everybody, welcome to Wilson Counseling. Today we're going to talk about mindful eating. I work a lot with people who have trouble with disordered eating, either restrictive eating, like a real full-on eating disorder, like bulimia, anorexia, binge eating disorder, or just people who struggle with eating in general and overeating, which is common for most of us to do at certain times, and certainly to do mindless eating where we're not really connected with the food. Mindfulness, you've probably heard a lot about mindfulness. It's really talking about being very conscious, being very aware, and being in the present moment. And when you eat mindfully, you're much more likely to be tuned into your body and to notice when you really truly are hungry and you're really truly are full, instead of just eating because the food is there or because you're bored or because you're sad or whatever it is. We're going to talk about some tips for doing mindful eating. This is something that people struggle with, but there's some really good techniques that if you go through it step by step, it's going to help you to be more connected with your food and really feel when you get full so that you can stop eating at that point. The first step is to concentrate and do some deep breathing. When we do deep breathing, it helps slow down all the rhythms of your body and it helps you feel more connected to your body. I would recommend doing just a simple, what I would call 5-5 breathing, which is 5 seconds in and 5 seconds out. I usually recommend you breathe in through your nose and breathe out through your mouth. And you want to breathe out so that all the air is out of your lungs. The exact number doesn't really matter, but basically just a slow breath, couple of slow breaths in and slow breaths out. A lot of times I like to close my eyes. I feel more relaxed and more connected when my eyes are closed, but you can do it with your eyes open or closed. And then you want to check in with your body and notice, do you feel hungry? Where do you feel that hunger? Do you notice your tummy is rumbling? Do you notice any contractions, any waves of just sort of feeling pressure or emptiness? The second step is to observe and pay attention to the food that you have in front of you. So let's say that you're going to be eating some soup that you have for lunch or dinner. I want you to look at the food itself, pay attention to what it looks like, what's the texture, does it have any smell to it? Just really focus in on all of the details of the food. And just ask yourself some questions about it. You know, what's the texture? Is it chewy? Is it smooth? Is it crunchy? Is it hot? Is it cold? What's the density? Is it heavy or light? Is it bitter or sweet? All of those kinds of things. Just get really tuned in and paying attention to the food. Step number 3 is you're going to close your eyes, because when your eyes are closed, all of your other senses will be heightened. So close your eyes and slowly take a bite of the food. So if it's your soup, you know, you'll just take your spoon and drink the soup. If you can, you want to hold that food in your mouth for a little bit before you actually start chewing, just to really taste the flavors. Fourth step, you're gonna swallow or trace the food as it goes down to your stomach. This is much easier to do if the food is very hot or cold, but you can do it with any food. So notice the food as it goes down your throat and into your stomach, especially if it's hot or cold or creamy. Notice that, notice how it feels in your body. If you can't really feel it very well, then just imagine the path that it takes as it goes in your body. Imagine your stomach feeling less empty as it slowly starts to fill up. The fifth step in mindful eating is to become aware of your whole body. So I really want you to tune back into your body and notice, are your muscles tense anywhere? Notice how you're sitting. Notice what the cushions feel like under you on your chair. Notice what you're thinking about. Are you thinking about the sensations of the food, or have other thoughts started intruding into your mind? And if you've just completely gone somewhere else, I want you to tune your attention back and just take a deep breath. So tune back into your body. The last step, or the sixth step in mindful eating, is you're gonna take a pen and pencil out, or you can use your phone if you prefer, and write down the sensations that you're feeling. What are the physical feelings? What are the flavors that you've noticed? The textures? And any other feelings that you might be experiencing when you're eating the food. And actually write it down. Don't just think about it in your mind, because things become a lot more concrete when we write them down. I would actually also recommend, in addition to these 6 steps, that you consider putting your utensil down after every bite, because it's also going to serve the process of slowing you down so that you can be more in tune and not just mindlessly eating the food. So these steps are fairly easy to follow. I know you're probably thinking that's a lot to it. It's a lot of steps, and it will feel like a lot of steps at the beginning, but what it's going to teach you to do is to be aware of your body and tuned into the food. Most people are not very connected with their food, and that's why so many people overeat on a regular basis. But if you eat more slowly, you're much more likely to get those fullness cues that your body has had enough food and you can stop eating. You're also a lot more likely to enjoy and really taste the flavors in the food that you're eating. And I would recommend you try this with at least one meal a day for the first month until you get used to the mindful eating process. And then after that, it will become a lot more natural. I hope these have been helpful tips on how to eat more mindfully. If you have enjoyed this, I hope you'll come back for more videos, and hope you guys have a great day.